Okay, this is a very interesting topic, but we rarely talk about it in a math class because this is more like physics. Here's a fact. If you have a Tesla Model S Plaid, this is a very fast car because you can go from 0 miles per hour to 60 miles per hour in just 2 seconds. Technically, if you Google this, you will see 1.99 seconds. But for simplicity purpose, I'm just going to put down 2. And when we have this information, we can calculate the average acceleration. And this right here is defined to be the rate of change of the speed over time. It tells you how fast we can increase the speed during a certain period of time. And let's just go ahead and compute the average acceleration for this situation. And here's a common mistake. From 0 to 60, of course, the increase is just 60 minus 0, and then divided by 2 seconds, which is 2, and then we just get 30, right? No, this is very wrong. Why? Because what's the unit? You didn't put on the unit, which is bad. Okay, fine. Let's see. 60 miles per hour minus 0, doesn't matter, divided by 2 seconds. So I'll put on 2s. Okay, right here, if you work this out as 60 over 2, which is 30 miles per hour per second, don't write it like mphs. That doesn't look right at all. P stands for per, which is like the division bar. You can write it like this, but don't write down m, because m usually stands for meters. So spell that out, miles per hour per second. If you put it down like this, it's technically okay, but nobody really does it. Well, if you do it, if it's okay, then fine. But usually, we want to have the units match. If this is hour, that should be hour. Or if this is second, that should be second. So this is what we are going to do first. Right here, we are going to convert 60 miles per hour, and the mile is like this, right? Miles per hour is like miles per 1 hour, like that. So I'm gonna change this to something over seconds. And to do so, we know that 1 hour equals 3600 seconds. And the reason I put the hour on the top is so that the hour unit can cancel. And now we have 60 miles over 3600 seconds. But another issue is, if you divide it by, you know, 60 divided by this, the number is pretty small. It's like 0.016. It's like miles. It's like, how do you visualize this? It's hard to do that, right? So if you have a small distance, usually, especially in the United States, we use feet. So we are going to do the following. We are going to convert the mile, and we know 1 mile is equal to 5,280 feet. And I put a mile on the bottom so that the miles can cancel. Now, all you have to do is just multiply this and this divided by this. The one doesn't matter. So if you work that out, you end up with 88 feet per second. All right. So now we are going to compute the average acceleration. So we go from 0 feet per second to 88 feet per second. So we do 88 feet per second minus 0 feet per second, which of course doesn't matter, over 2 seconds. So now 88 divided by 2 is 44. Be careful with the unit. We have feet per second per second. So we divide the second twice. So it's second to the second power. So per second squared. And you can write it down like this. So this is the reason why when we have the acceleration, the unit is per the time unit squared. Right? You have, because you divide the time twice. And that's it. That's the average acceleration when you go from 0 to 60 in 2 seconds. Okay, so here's a question for you guys. It takes 2 seconds to go from 0 to 60 miles per hour. So what if we go for another 2 seconds? Then what will be the speed right here? Right? Let me know.